Alright, what's going on, you guys? My name is Quiet R, and today I'll be watching Five Ghosts and Demons Call on tape and audio. Try to get a little reaction off of this. So, I saw it on one of the feeds, and I was like, oh, it's like pretty interesting. So, I was like, let me just give it a try and look at it. Get some type of reaction, some type of scary reaction, something off, you know. I don't get scared that easily, but I'm used to scary stuff. Love horror movies and everything, so. Whoever's scared, buckle your seatbelts, because this is going to be crazy. It looks crazy. That's a, from what I saw, it looks crazy. Cheap jump scare. Cheap jump scare. The storyteller.
Thousands of videos and audio recordings of what people believe are real demons and ghosts are uploaded to the internet each year. Most of these recordings are either fake or can be explained one way or another. But there are a few videos and audio recordings out there that cannot be explained, and many people believe them to be real.
Number 5.
The Triangleville Ghost. During the American Civil War in 1863, a bloody battle took place at the Triangle Field, which is located in Gettysburg. Tens of thousands of Civil War soldiers.
What I noticed about most of these, like, top 5 scary this, top 5, top 10, whatever, I understand they put up the scariness, and they want to creep you out as much as they can. And it's funny, because every time they, like, his voice is just too hilarious. Like, it's just 1986. I'm like, bruh, come on. Like, I understand it though. You know, like, there's one dude named Chills. Like, he got the best voice for his videos. And I be shook myself. Like, I can't even watch it on my phone. I gotta have the light on or something. Watch some of his videos. He got some good videos, but it's just hilarious. Like, these guys really be emphasizing their voice, especially this dude right here. But he's good though. He's good, somewhat.
Either killed or injured during the battle.
See what I'm talking about?
In November 2001, the alien Tom Underwood was visiting the Triangle Field, and they were able to capture one of the most compelling ghost footage ever to be recorded. In the video, you see what it looks like. Civil War soldiers walking around in the forest.
Damn. Y'all may not see it, or your eyes not adjusting to it, but like, there's like a little blur of gray stuff just going by. That's creepy.
We're Rhett and Link. We wanted to show you how we created our amazing new website with Wix. Now, we know that having a great website...
That's what I forgot to do in my other videos. Take out the commercials. Oh, well.
The Connecticut Poltergeist. There aren't that much information about the following case, and the family members' identities are protected. So if you have any more information about this specific case, please let me know in the comments below. The following video was recorded by Ed and Rena Warren. During one of their investigations, a family in Connecticut were being tormented by a poltergeist. In the video, Kissel's 10-year-old daughter are trying to do her homework, while the poltergeist are trying to slide her chair backwards. In the next clip, Casey, Ed and Rena Warren, along with the family, when they are trying to contact the poltergeist, by asking questions and telling it to knock one time for yes, and knock two times for no.
One knock for yes, two for no. Are you a man? Are you a boy?
Ed asks the poltergeist which family member it dislikes the most. At first, everything is quiet, but when Ed asks if it is the mother that it doesn't like, one knock can be heard.
Is it their mother?
Yeah.
Ed then tries to confront the poltergeist on his own and commands it to reveal its identity. Nothing happens until Ed tells it to give him a sign, and two chairs can then be seen moving. When Ed then commands the poltergeist to reveal its identity,
this guy's voice, moves. Man.
I command you to reveal your identity.
An exorcist was later performed by three priests in the house, and the poltergeist disappeared.
God damn.
Maurice Theriault. When Maurice was just a child, his father confessed to his wife that he and Maurice were both possessed. Before killing her and taking his own life, Maurice would later grow up to become a farmer in a small town located in Massachusetts. He lived with his family that consisted of his wife and two children, and was known by the locals as Frenchie. In the spring of 1985, the locals began to notice some unusual behavior from Maurice and at his house. Maurice turned in his gun to the sheriff and told him not to give it back. Blood would randomly appear on Maurice and throughout the house. Maurice and his family also claimed to hear unknown voices in the house. Ed and Lorraine Warren was later contacted, and they later arrived to the house. The Warrens felt an evil presence in the house, and they experienced many different paranormal activities, such as horrifying screams, child whispers, and physical attacks. The Warrens concluded that this was not a normal haunting, but that Maurice was possessed. The Warrens called Bishop Robert McKenna and asked him to do an exorcism.
Damn.
Robert agreed on performing an exorcism, and he later arrived to the house. The Warrens recorded the exorcism, and I was able to find some of the footage that has been released. In the video, you see how Maurice's skin appears to bubble, and a deep crack appears on his forehead. It is also said that blood appeared in Maurice's eyes, and that his eyes at one point appeared serpent-like. The demon identified itself as Maurice's eyes
that creeped me
actually
out.
Rolled back.
That actually creeped
me
out.
The exorcist was thought to be successful, but 1 year later, Maurice shot his wife with his shotgun, and he made her watch as he took his own life. His wife later told the Warrens that before Maurice shot himself, it looked like he was fighting with someone to gain control over the shotgun. This makes many to believe that the demon had returned and possessed Maurice once again. But this time, the demon came to finish the job.
Damn. Ah, damn.
The Enfield Poltergeist. Peggy Hodgson and her four children lived in their home in Enfield, which is located in Britain. In August 1977,
Peggy
called the police after two of her children claimed that they heard knocking sounds and that furniture moved by itself. A police arrived at the house, and he claims to have seen a chair slide on the floor by itself, and that he could hear demonic voices. Not long after, British newspaper began to cover the story. Two journalists named Graham Morris and Douglas Bench later arrived to the house to conduct an interview with the family and try to capture any paranormal activities on photograph. After 1 hour, nothing had happened, but just as they prepared to leave the house, objects began to fly around the room, crashing into walls and people. Two paranormal researchers named Morris Cruz and Guy Lyon Playfair later contacted Peggy, asking to be allowed to investigate the paranormal activities. Peggy gave her permission to the two paranormal researchers. The two paranormal researchers, with the help of a photographer
and
a mirror, set up a camera in the girl's bedroom that would take a photograph every 4 seconds whenever it was activated. The camera was able to capture a series of photographs of one of the children, named Janet, being pulled out of her bed. Janet would later begin to speak in a very deep voice, and during an interview, she claimed that the voice came from an old man named Bill that had died on the first floor.
How many voices are there?
600
voices.
I know the joke.
Oh, there.
How many really are there, Margaret?
I think so far we've had 10.
Three.
Sensible voices. But the rest of the names are absolute rubbish.
A man named Terry Williams later contacted Morris and told
told him that y'all may not believe this, but I believe this. Lived in the house before the hot sauce. This is audio footage. That he had died in a chair on the first floor. Many other paranormal researchers have investigated the case. Some believe it to just be a hoax, and some believe it to be real. Two paranormal researchers that believe that the Enfield poltergeist is real. Poltergeist, my guy. Visited the family several times, and Ed Warren claimed that Janet one time began to levitate in midair while asleep. The Warrens believed that the children were the subjects of demonic possession. The Enfield poltergeist is one of the most documented poltergeist cases in the world. The Enfield poltergeist is also Conjuring. Inspiration I told you, Conjuring for a horror movie called The Conjuring 2, featuring Ed and Lorraine Warren.
We'll stop. Seen some lady with some bulging red eyes. I don't know what that was about, but you know, I had to catch you with the thumbnails. Of September
1952, and was like any other girl at the time, but that would later change. In 1968, Annelise began to shake uncontrollably and was later diagnosed with epilepsy. After the epilepsy attack, Annelise became very depressed and was admitted for treatment at the hospital. Not long after, Annelise began to see demonic faces while praying. Later in 1974, the demonic faces were still haunting Annelise, and she could now also hear sinister whispers saying things like, "Annelise will steal Annelise." The doctors couldn't help, and the medicine didn't work. So Annelise's family now thought that Annelise was possessed, and he contacted the church, asking them to do an exorcism. The church rejected the family's request, so they turned to Pastor Ernst's aunt, and he too asked for permission to perform an exorcism on Annelise. But just like the first time, the church rejected his request, and they told him that Annelise had to live an even more of a religious lifestyle in order to find peace. Over time, Annelise's behavior became more violent. She attacked her family members, biting and hitting them. She refused to eat normal food, saying that the demons would not allow it. The only thing she ate was insects, like spiders and flies, and she even began to drink her own urine. Annelise was also known to scream for hours on end while destroying paintings of Jesus and crucifix. Later in 1975, Pastor Ernst Alt and Father Arnold Ranch finally got permission from the church to perform an exorcism on Annelise. Arnold and Ernst concluded that Annelise was possessed by several demons. Some of the more known demons that Annelise was possessed by was Judas, Hitler, and even Lucifer himself. Arnold and Ernst would perform one or two exorcisms each week. During the exorcism, Annelise would sometimes become so violent that three men had to hold her down in order to be able to perform the exorcism. During the exorcism, Arnold and Ernst recorded over 40 audio tapes to document the case, and the following audio is recorded from one of the exorcists. Seemed to work, and Annelise began to return to normal, and she was able to go back to school. Even though she was able to go back to school, the demonic faces and attacks did not stop entirely. Arnold and Ernst still performed one or two exorcisms each week for several months. Annelise's violent and uncontrollable behavior later returned, and this time it wouldn't go away. On June the 30th, 1976, the last exorcism was performed, and Annelise would unfortunately die the following day. Her last words to her mother was,
"Mother, I am afraid."
Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button to support my channel and subscribe for more videos. And if you want to support me,
I'm good, bro. I'm good. Damn. That's something. That's sad. Got no control to get your soul back. Anything. It's just the worst. But that was you know, Five Ghosts and Demons caught on tape and audio. Some of it is already known, like Conjuring 1 and 2. That's like a well-known one. They made a movie out of it. But that last one, that's pretty sad. That's sad. And that's why so many priests don't want to do exorcism, because sometimes, as much as they do it, it works. Person's back to normal, and then all of a sudden, creeps back on them. But that's how it is. I mean, I don't know. Either way, that was... Okay. Either way, that was the video. Check you guys in the next one.